come away from Norman, Oklahoma?
Well, in a way, and what they have to do, Drew, is maintain poise, and they can't lose it like they did in this game. Too many penalties for too many yards.
Monte Jones tackles Hodges Mitchell. Let's take a look at our Dr. Pepper player of the game. How about the quarterback? They call him Opie. You can see why. He's a redhead. He's our Dr. Pepper player of the game, Major Applewhite. Good day in the air. That's a career high.
And he looks like he's your paper boy. I mean, he looks like a young kid out there dropping off the morning newspaper, but he's deadly. Completing over 50% of his passes for close to 300 yards, two touchdowns, one interception.
Second down, not much doing again for Mitchell. You see a team starting to feel a whole lot better about themselves, and the way this season started for Texas, tough loss to UCLA, they were really handled by Kansas State, and now they're starting to feel good about themselves, not only offensively, I think they always did on offense, but defensively.
Well, and Mack Brown basically had to make sure that the level of trust with the new coaching staff and the players remained high. They could have lost their season in those blowouts to UCLA and Kansas State, but they haven't. They've maintained the course.
Ryan O'Neal hands off. And sweeping wide, 33, is Chris Robertson. And he may have gotten the first down. Chris Robertson, who normally wears number 37, of course, today, in honor of Doak Walker, Ricky Williams wore 37. And Chris asked his head coach, can I wear 34 for a game? What'd he say, Dave?
33. You're going to wear number 33, not 34 today.
Said, I don't think you want any part of 34, son.
Now, Earl Campbell, it's pretty much legendary right there.
And that will be the final snap of the 93rd edition of the Red River Shootout. And it will be a memorable one for the Texas Longhorns in their biggest win in the series since 1970. They've thrown a knockout blow to the Oklahoma Sooners today. 34-3, the final.
In the story of this football game, early on Oklahoma had their chances. They could have been up 10-0 if it weren't for penalty. They had self-inflicted a lot of damage. And over the course of the football game, the theme continued. They'd start to make something positive happen, like an opening half opening to the second half kickoff return, short field for a touchdown opportunity, fumble the football. The Texas come right back with a 97-yard touchdown pass to really take full control of this football game. 14-point swing right there. Instead of being a one-score game, it became a three-score game, and for all practical purposes, game was over at that point, right at the start of the second half.
Well, the tower in Austin on the campus of the University of Texas will be bright orange tonight.
Look at the stadium. Oklahoma, all the fans have already gone to the fair. The Texas Longhorn fans want to revel in all this post-game celebration before they go for their corn dogs.
The song of the day will be the Eyes of Texas. Boomer Sooner will have to wait for another day. Now let's go downstairs. Jim Nouts with Mack Brown. Jim, take it away.
All right, thanks, Drew. Coach, a complete domination today on both sides of the football. You guys came out, took it right to them, and end up 34-3 victorious.
Well, Jim, OU's got a real good football team, and we had our crowd into it today. Ricky Williams is a great player. I hate he had the 80-yarder callback. Young freshman quarterback played well, but our defense played as well as they've played all year. If we could continue to play like that on defense, we can be a good football team.
Yeah, you talk about the defense. I thought it set the tone in the second half. They got the long kickoff return. Defense comes up with a big play at the goal line.
Defense came up with a big play. We've talked about our team playing as one heartbeat. We caused the fumble at the one and then threw the deep pass for the touchdown for 99 yards on about the third play after that. And that's what you call being a great football team and playing together.
How about the play a Major Applewhite tonight. They said he played like a general, and he did just that.
Well, Major's played that way every week. People thought this game might get to him, but when your first game is at Kansas State against the number one defense in the country, this is still a classic. It's always been. It's a great rivalry. It's so much fun, but Major Applewhite's a good football player.
14 years ago, you were on the other sidelines involved in a 15-all tie. Today, you take it. I'm the head coach of the Texas Longhorns. That has to be a big thrill.
Well, it is. It's a big thrill for me, and we'll have many more of these.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you
very much. Ricky Williams, of course, the big story in this game, two touchdowns, 139 yards. Major Applewhite well over the 250-yard mark as well. Drew?
All right, Jim, thanks very much. Congratulations to Texas. They win it 34-3. Time for our BMW play of the day. And this was the knockout blow, Dave.
It really was. Major Applewhite looking off his receiver, trying to look the safety away, but McGarity just absolutely outruns Ivy. Just nothing fancy about it. Applewhite over the top, and McGarity outrunning everybody. 97-yard touchdown pass, longest in Texas school history, and it was coffin nails in that game.
And Ricky Williams, 139 yards unofficially on the ground. He passed Herschel Walker earlier today, and he's down with Jim Knox.
All right, thanks a lot, Drew. Ricky, a very emotional day, I'm sure, for you. You come back. Bill Walker, a great friend of yours, a couple of weeks ago passed away. You have number 37 on today. How emotional was this game today?
Well, I came out here, and, you know, I was proud to wear this number in the house that he built, and I think our team did a great job, you know, to let me pay a tribute to him in a very big way.
Two touchdowns, 139 yards of rushing. As far as today goes, that's not a bad day for Ricky Williams at the office.
It's not a bad day. They came in, you know, trying to stop the run. They put nine men on the line of scrimmage, and it gave us opportunity to hit them in the passing game.
When you went into the end zone on that one touchdown run, you pointed up to the sky. What was that all about?
I knew Doug was watching me and helping me get some yards to me.
Congratulations. Ricky Williams, not only a great running back, but a great individual off the field. Drew?
You can say that again. No question about that. Thanks, Jim. And Ricky Williams, thanks very much. He got in the end zone twice today. Got in from 20 yards away early. Texas rolls over Oklahoma 34-3. We're back in a moment.
Take off on the voyage of a lifetime. Exotic destinations. Never-ending adventure. A state-of-the-art ship with endless activities. Set sail on Royal Caribbean's Nordic Empress for a three-night Bahama cruise and two-night stay in Orlando, Florida from $535 per person. If you call now, you can receive a free upgrade. Or sail the Southern Caribbean with a three-night cruise and two-night stay in San Juan, Puerto Rico from $568 per person. Call now for your free upgrade. For more details, call the 800 number on your screen.
Do you have trouble driving in the rain? Is the glare unbearable at night? That's why STP created Vision Blade Glass Treatment. Vision Blade forms an invisible barrier that repels water and virtually eliminates glare. It applies in minutes, and it lasts for 6 months. This muddy water sticks to the glass on the untreated side. But with Vision Blade, the dirt and grime sheets away, and your view remains clear. And now Vision Blade is available in two sizes to meet all drivers' needs. See what you've been missing with Vision Blade.
And they ended up getting blown out.
And for Oklahoma defensively, a pretty solid effort is really lost.
It really is. I mean, the offense didn't hold up their end of the bargain. Special teams, they got a couple of things happen on special teams. They had a great opening second half kickoff to no avail, once again because of turnover. When you think of rivalries, you have to think field position. Oklahoma wasn't in bad shape there. Turnovers, terrible shape there. And ultimately, though, as it comes down to in Pee Wee football, high school football, college football, and the National Football League, you have to win the battle at the line of scrimmage. And today, Texas, the Hogs between the hash marks for Texas, won this football game.
Two schools representing two states where football passion runs as high as anywhere in the country. And for the University of Texas, they'll struggle a little bit stronger tonight as they win it 34-3 over Oklahoma. Well, plan to join us next Saturday morning at 11:30 for our next Big 12 football game of the week. Check your local listings as always. Again, the final 34-3. Now for Dave Lapham and Jim Knox, I'm Drew Goodman saying so long from the Cotton Bowl in Dallas.
This year, the colors of fall are brown, red, yellow, and at your Buick dealer, lots of green. Because right now, during Buick's Fall Collection event, we've got great deals like 0.9% APR financing on every 1998 Buick in stock, or cash back savings of up to $3,000. So come in and see our fall collection. But hurry, because when the 98 Buicks are gone, the Buick Fall Collection will be too.
It just doesn't get any better than this. Hi, I'm Jenny Covert, and when you buy your new Chevy from Covert Country, you can get 0.9% financing with no money down and no payment till next year. Drive a 98 Chevy three-door Metro for just $86.88. We're closing out the 98s, and the 99s are arriving, so don't delay. It just doesn't get any better than 0.9% financing at Covert Country. Central Texas's number one Chevy dealer, Highway 71 in Bastrop, and now in Taylor.
They've had to do a little remodeling at Pizza Hut headquarters since their co-founder came out of retirement to become a Papa John's franchisee. See, he thinks Papa John's makes better pizza than even the company he helped found. Today, Frank owns over 70 restaurants.
Papa John's. Better ingredients, better pizza.
He's got it.
Papa John's.
Hey, looks good here.
Try our Papa's Choice. That's a large pizza with your choice of up to five toppings for just $9.99.
This is Imagine TV.
The Big Mountaineer Drive Away is on its way again, where you can fill up with $500 worth of gas from Diamond Shamrock or Total when you buy or lease a new Mercury Mountaineer. Enough gas to go coast to coast three times. Plus, besides filling up with $500 worth of gas, fill up with big savings. We'll cover your first month's payment up to $500. But hurry, the Big Mountaineer Drive Away ends soon, so drive in now.
Till next time, imagine yourself in a Mercury.
The discovery that could cost Mulder's life. Watch The X-Files at a special time, Sunday at 10:05 on Fox 7.
Welcome back to Atlanta. We get ready for the start of game number two.
Hello there, my old friend. Not so long ago. That's how it happened, living life by the drive.
Overwhelming performance by Brown.
It's the Xerox National League Championship pregame show, brought to you by the document company, Xerox. Keep the conversation going. Share the knowledge.
Well, here in San Diego, it's not dead like it was at the Ted. 65,000 Padres fans, a sellout,
here at the Mighty Q are on hand for Game 3 of the National League Championship Series between the San Diego Padres and the Atlanta Braves. They are roaring, they are rocking, they are ready to go. And the Braves might be reeling, folks. They're down 2-0 with Game 3 coming up here in a few minutes right here on Fox. Hello again, everybody. I'm Chip Carey, and welcome to the Xerox National League Championship pregame show. As always, I'm joined by my partner, Steve Lyons. What a change of venue. What a change in excitement and electricity. This place is about to burst.
And these fans have good reason to be that excited. This Padre pitching staff has done an unbelievable job all year long. They've never been given any respect. You want to hear about respect? The 3, 4, 5, 6 hitters in that Brave lineup, they're 3 for 28. They have no home runs, no RBIs. I think they deserve a little bit of respect for that pitching
staff.
Well,
these Padres aren't careful.